Hi there. A top story on Indian Express Opinion Videos is the absolutely chaotic admissions process at Delhi University. Even as we speak, the first list of the admissions process has come to an end. Over the next few days, the second list will come out. Students from all over the country apply at Delhi University. It is one of the most coveted universities and, of course, has some of the country's most coveted colleges. But to explain this whole story, why there is this kind of chaos and what can be done to improve it, I have with me Shraddha Chhetri, ace correspondent of the Indian Express. Shraddha, yeah. Tell me, why is it so chaotic? Why are they, is it because of the numbers that Delhi University cannot handle? Tell me a little bit.
Yeah, so what happens is Delhi University, for the last few years, they've made this entire process a centralized process.
Okay.
So for 61 colleges and around 56,000 seats, it is the university who is handling everything.
So one second. So there are 61 colleges at Delhi University.
Delhi University, yeah.
And you're saying there are 56,000 seats, yeah, across the university.
College,
okay.
Yeah.
And how many applications for these 61
this
colleges?
Year the university received around close to 3 lakh applications, though that's been a drop from what it was last year.
How much was it last year?
Last year was close to 3.5.
okay, so it's about 50,000 people less applying.
Yeah.
And some of those may have gone to private universities.
Yeah, probably.
Okay.
Yeah,
but you're saying that it's the centralized admissions process that's a
because,
problem.
Because they do not, previous years also, the system that they work in is not been very competent enough. And right now, though, every year they've been, you can see improvement, but it is not like there'll be no glitches every time from the application process to the admission process.
So what's the system? When you say the system is not proper, what does that mean?
So earlier what was happening was last year it was the University South Campus, the computer science department, who was handling this.
Okay.
So few students and teachers got together and they were monitoring it and they were doing it.
Mm-hmm.
Now this time it has been shifted to the computer science department, which is there in the North Campus. So
okay.
You know, so somehow technicality of it, or they can't understand the kind of volume that they're going to receive. So they're not generally prepared
for
it.
So is the system crashing, are you saying?
Yeah, system does, because when the first day of application process started, system does crash, right?
And so the system crashed on the first day?
Yeah, first day there was problem. Students could not apply. When they had said they will start the application process at 6 p.m., by the time it started, it had almost become 9 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, so that way is...
So everybody is getting very nervous about applying.
And when a student, as an applicant, you can't log in, the sense of anxiety is more. So
that's
you
right.
Just keep on going to the system and then there is a lot of traffic.
And that loads the system even more.
Yeah, and they are not competent enough to handle that.
So Delhi University has to get its act together.
Yeah, exactly. It has to, either you hire professionals or,
private parties
or increase your server load or something of that sort. But yeah, they've been proved incompetent to actually handle the kind of traffic that they get.
Right.
And also in that, because it is not only the UG admission that they're handling, they also
undergraduate
have the
admissions.
Yeah, it's not only the undergraduate. They also have the postgraduate, MPhil, PhD. So, you know, That increases.
So now the first list has the cutoffs have
that's
taken place. Mm-hmm. Now what happens?
So now today till the midnight, students who have got the confirmation and who have submitted the documents.
So midnight of 29th of June.
Yeah, 29th of June. The students who have finished their application process and can pay their fees.
All right.
Because from the last year, university has made online payment of fees compulsory.
Okay.
Earlier, what used to happen was once you got admission in a college, you could go to the college bank and make the payment. But now it is...
So everything is online.
Everything is online.
Is that contributing to the chaos?
Yeah, a lot. Because on the first day, under the first list, when the admission happened, students could not go pay the fees.
Mm-hmm.
And so they were worried that whether the application has been accepted.
So you cannot go to the college anymore and say, here is the money and can you please accept it?
That is not at all possible. So
all
you
right.
Go online, make the payment, and then get a confirmation from there. That's how it happens.
So now tell me, the cutoffs, which are absolutely astronomically high in Delhi University, there, you know, you hear of 93, 94, 95%.
Yeah.
What? Tell me about the in say English literature, what was the highest cutoff?
The English literature, this time the highest cutoff was 98.75 at HGTV Khalsa College.
Okay.
So, yeah, but...
What about at LSR, at Lady Shriram College?
Yeah, LSR was also, LSR was second after it, so theirs was around 98. Though they had come down compared to the previous year.
How much has it come down?
2.5.
2.5%.
Percent, yeah.
In English literature.
Yeah, 0.25%. Okay. Not, yeah. So okay. It's very minimal.
So Khalsa College was 98.75, and yeah. LSR Lady Shriram College was 98%.
Yeah.
So what happens to the other colleges, like, and what about Shriram College of Commerce?
So Shriram College does not have English.
Yeah,
so
no, but in the other commerce subjects.
For commerce and economics, their percentage had come down this time. So
how much
this time
that?
It was 97.75, both for economics honours and for BCom honours. So that was a fall by 0.25 again.
What about St. Stephen's?
Okay, St. Stephen's has a different percentage.
Yes, because it's
process,
a minority institution.
College,
but I'm just asking about the percentages.
So I think St. Stephen's, their cutoff was around 98.25 for English, 98 for economics, for political, for history it was 97.75. So if you see all big colleges, irrespective of which course, the cutoffs are not below 95.
Okay, so where are these students coming from? Are they mostly from Delhi? Or what parts of India are they from most?
So interestingly, what has happened is, if you go to SRCC, right, and that is one hub where everybody wants to, a commerce student wants to go. But out of the 501 seats they have, the teacher told me that they filled almost the 400 seats.
In the first list?
First list. And so not, the college does not want to say, but people who are part of the admission committee.
Sure.
So there are a lot of students coming from the southern part of the country who actually have that kind of a percentage and they want to do commerce from SRCC. So they've been taking admission.
And what about the humanities? Which is the most difficult college to get into?
I think
history, political science.
I think that was LSR, because LSR is one college where, you know, the percentages have always remained high. So and this time also it's pretty on the higher side of it. So
in the second list, out of these 56,000 seats that are taken, how many seats would be taken already in the first list?
So around the 1/4 of it, that means around 14,000 seats have already been taken.
Okay.
So
about 42,000 are left.
Are still left. So
and how many lists come out by the end of
this year? The university has said that they've given a schedule for five lists.
Mm-hmm.
But they said in case these seats remain vacant, we will consider and then release other lists. So we really don't know exactly how they're going to do about it. But till the fifth list, they have a proper schedule given by the
university. So last couple of questions, Shraddha. Yeah. The first is that you said that the number of applications had dropped, say, about 50,000. Is that because a lot of students are going to private universities like Ashoka, Shivnadar, Jindal, at least in the Delhi sort of region, but all over the country?
Yeah, I think that also could be the reason, and also the little drop in the application was this time a student was not allowed to register more than twice. So, you know, they did not want to have the duplicity. So that because of which the numbers could have gone down. But yes, because I meet parents, I meet students.
Right.
So yeah, there are a lot of them who go to private universities because their first choice is either the elite and the popular colleges in North Campus and few in South Campus. So once they can't get into this, they do not want to go to the colleges who are a little... who are not very known that way. So,
well, Delhi University remains this amazing sort of center of excellence. But to you, Shraddha, what do you think DU should do to improve this so that next year students don't face this kind of chaos?
So I think it is always, when there's a system is decentralized, it always works fine, right?
Mm-hmm.
So let the, okay, if you find you want to have a centralized process of application, you do that. But I think after that, you let it to the colleges to handle, right? Because colleges are also competent
enough
to...
instead of centralizing it, you have to
decentralize
that.
Yeah. After whatever happens, let college, because colleges also have their IT and server well in place. So let
and
colleges...
And they have the experience to deal with it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm afraid that's all we have for now. I don't think there's anything more that needs to be said. Shraddha has explained the story beautifully, the chaos that comes with the anxiety and the nervousness that comes with having your child apply at Delhi University and wonder whether he or she is going to get admitted. But hang in there. I'm sure something will come out of it. Thank you so much for watching.